In case of refraction, first, if I ask you, I think you know one thing, that is basic concept of this refraction. When light ray enters from denser medium to rarer medium to denser medium, how it moves, that you know. It bends towards the normal or away from the normal?
Towards normal.
Towards the normal, and your angle of refraction, we take it as a part. Okay. And if suppose if the refractive indices, I take them as mu r and mu d. Snell's law, you can say. What is the Snell's law?
Mu 2 by mu 1, mu d by mu r d equal to mu 2 by mu 1.
Mu 2 by mu 1. That is equals to sin a by sin r. Snell's law.
Yes, sir.
I think you know it. Mu of tensor with respect to error. In this case, will you tell what will be the deviation of incident light? Means instead of going straight like this, it took this much deviation, bent towards the normal. So in this case, deviation is equals to, you're taking that I minus R. Very good. This is equals to I minus R. This is the case when light enters from rarer to denser. If light enters from denser to rarer, suppose I take the same as R, mu R, and this is denser, and it is mu B, then how the light bends, you know, away from the normal. And in this case, will you tell the deviation on it? Deviation from its original path?
R minus I, sir.
Very good, R minus I. And in this case, the Snell's law, which is sin I by sin R equals to what I suppose you to write here?
Mu D by mu R.
Light is coming from denser to rarer.
Yes, sir. Mu R
by mu. Mu 2 by mu R is mu R by mu. Okay. This is mu of rare with respect to denser. These two concepts, you know, Nana. And based on this concept, suppose if he gave one question like this. He is saying that the relative refractive index of, say, some denser medium with respect to rarer medium, that is root 3 at an angle. And the angle of incidence is equals to 60 degrees, what he gives. Okay. In this case, he gave the question like, a parallel beam of light rays. Parallel beam of light rays incident on the interface, and they enter into the denser medium while entering, all of you know what, bent towards the normal. Here, like this. In this case, the question is, the width of incident light rays, width means the perpendicular distance between the light rays. Width of incident light rays is suppose T1, and width of refracted light rays means perpendicular drawn onto this light ray. This is the width of the refracted light rays. Then the ratio of their widths, T1 by T2 equals to how much? If they ask, here how to solve this type of question. Okay. In this case, sin i by sin r, mu is equals to sin i by sin r, I is 60 degrees. Sin r will be how much, Nana, from this? 3 by 2. I think 1 by 2. Am I right? So R will be
30.
sin r is equals to half means r is equals to 30 degrees. That you know now. Okay. Then how to use the given information I is equals to 30 degrees and the information what we found r equals to 30 degrees here. Okay. Try to get some idea. Here what I am saying. What will be this angle here now?
Incidence, sir.
Very good. Angle of incidence means, look at it is a right angle triangle. Na?
Yes, sir.
And this angle is 90 minus I. Na?
Yes, sir.
If it is 90 minus I, can I say this angle is I?
Yes, sir.
Then look at here. Can I say cos I equals to adjacent side means this is hypotenuse. Na? Why? Because it is right angle. Are you
one by
T1 by you give some name like T and Q here.
X, sir.
Some X or PQ.
Cancel it by T1 by T2 equal to option, sir.
In the same way, cos R equals to T2 by PQ. Very good. Then you will get this is R. Okay, means as usual. If it is R here also, 90 minus, this is R. Yeah, what you said correct. Cos R, T1 by T2, how much you are getting now? Cos I by?
Cos R.
Cos R. Right. I think now you can say cos I of 60 degrees now. Cos R.
1 by 3 by 2. 1 by root 3.
Yes. 1 by root. Okay. This is the ratio of widths of incident and parallel, incident and refracted rays. Okay, now? Right. This is one example related to how to use the Snell's law in a different form. Okay?
Sir.
This model previously given, keep in mind.
Okay, sir.
And then, here again, I think you know this model in your 10th class. Suppose this is one parallel threaded glass slab. Suppose, suppose the thickness of glass slab is given as P is equals to thickness. Some 2 centimeters here given. Right? Light ray is coming from air. Refracts towards the normal as usual, bends towards the normal, and then here suppose while entering into air again it bends away from the normal. I think if these two media are equal, then the incident light ray and refracted light ray both will be parallel to each other. Think that they are parallel to each other. So this is the incident light. Here this is the angle of incidence and as usual this is the angle of refraction. Okay. And if you give the names like P, Q and here this is R and that is S. Okay. First question, here the refractive index of the medium is equals to 2 nana. Okay. And angle of incidence is equals to I is equals to 45 degrees. This is the information given to us. Then what is the distance traveled by light in the glass slab? First question. Please first identify what is this distance traveled by light in glass slab.
PQ, sir.
Yes, PQ. This is the distance traveled by the light in a glass bulb. So he is asking EQ is equals to how much? Is it possible to find out EQ there now?
Yes, sir.
How?
Sir, ఇప్పుడు ట్రయాంగిల్ PQR లో cos r equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, sir.
Very good. So cos r is equals to adjacent PR by PQ. Therefore PQ is equals to PR, we know, I think. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
PR is equals to the thickness of glass bulb, which is 2 cm given by cos r. I can substitute 2 here, Nana, centimeters by cos r. R, I don't know.
Sin r equal to root 2, sir.
Yeah, right. So, Snell's law you are using. Mu is equals to sin I by sin r. Sin r equals to how much you are getting, Nana?
1 by 2 root 2.
1 by 2 root 2. Ah, right. Sin r equals to 1 by 2 root 2 means I require cos r.
Theta equal to opposite 2 root 2 1.
I think it is root 7.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. Why? Because root of 1 square plus root 7 whole square is root 8. So root 8 is the hypotenuse. Root 8 is nothing but 2 root 2. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
So cos r is equals to root 7 by 2 root 2. Now simply you directly substitute them. Therefore PQ is equals to 2 by cos r root 7 by 2 root 2. That is equals to 4 of root of 2 by 7. Is it correct, Nana?
Yes,
sir. So one question is, what is the length of means the distance traveled by the light in the glass bulb? Second question, I think you know. What is the lateral shift? Lateral shift means what, Nana?
U nunchi perpendicular distance to PS by R.
Very good. So if you draw a perpendicular here, give some other name, PQRS, suppose this is P. Then what I require, QT equals to how much? QT, which is the lateral displacement. Perpendicular distance between the incident light ray and refracted lateral displacement.
Sir, angle QPT is I minus R, sir.
Very good. So this is I minus R.
Sin of I minus R.
Right. Sin of I minus R equals to this is equals to what to write, Anna? Opposite side QT by
PQ.
PQ. Therefore QT equals to PQ into sin I minus R. Formula wise, how to write? PQ is equals to P by cos R. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Into sin I minus R. Okay. T by cos R already we found, Nana. That is 4 into root of 2 by 7. So we have to find out only sin I minus R.
Sin of I minus A minus B formula.
Very good. So substitute, Nana, like sin I cos R minus cos I sin. Do it. So if I take 1 root 2 out, it will be cancelled. So 4 by 7 into 1 root 2 get cancelled. 2 7 by 2. So how much you got, Nana?
1 minute. root 2 by 7 into root 7 minus 1, sir.
Root 2? Okay. Right, this is lateral shift. Right, and here the theoretical question is, if these two mediana on both sides of the palisade glass are same, like air, then we can say the incident light ray and finally the emergent light ray are parallel to each other. They are parallel. And here the angle of emergence is exactly equals to angle of incidence. Why? Because both the media are same.
But in exam,
what they ask, suppose this is water, okay, and one parallel sided glass slab is placed like this setup, okay, means this is the parallel sided glass slab, and bottom one is water, this is glass, whereas this is air, okay. Then in that case, it is the angle of incidence, like in the same way, suppose 45 degrees. And of course, you can find out the angle of refraction here. Suppose the refractive index of the medium mu with respect to air, okay, is root 2. And here angle of refraction you can find out. And while coming out, the light ray suppose comes out like this. Is the incident light ray and the emergent light ray, are they, I mean, sir, those two are parallel or not?
Equally the parallel, sir.
Media equally the parallel. Now I think these two media are equal, Nana.
Yes. No, sir.
Then the incident and the emergent are parallel?
No, sir.
So here in this case we say incident and emergent rays are not parallel to each other. Okay. In this case, if they are not parallel, then you can't say, like in the above problem, the emergent angle is equal to 45 degrees. Can you say, Nana?
No, sir.
Then we have to find out, in this case, suppose you take it as one other example. Find out the angle of emergence. I am not asking lateral shift. I am not asking the length of means the distance traveled by the light in the glass slab. Just I am asking what is the angle of emergence in this case. Then do you have any idea? Can I give one hint here now? What is this angle?
R, sir.
Very good. I think you can find out R here.
Yes, sir.
Using the Snell's law. Find out that R first. Mu 2 by mu. Root 2 by 1. Equals to sin I by sin.
Sin R, sir.
Very good. So R equals to, you got 30 degrees. Okay, right. These two sides are parallel or non-parallel?
Parallel, sir.
Parallel means alternating angle. Here also the angle is R inside.
30, sir. And,
this is also 30
degrees. 30 plus 9. Sir, mottam 180 kabatti.
Oh, you can't say Nana.
Okay, sir.
Right, because here medium is changed.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So I think again you have to apply the Snell's law. Then I have to write light is coming from glass to water. So mu 2 by mu 1 means what I have to write?
Mu R by mu D. I mean mu glass by mu water.
Light is coming from glass to water. Glass to water means who is the second medium?
Water.
So mu 2 by mu 1 equals to sin I Here, I how much? Sine 30 by sine r.
Yes, sir.
How much?
Index.
Means you are asking what is the refractive index of water. Okay. That refractive index of water with respect to air is 4 by 3 now. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Then what will be sine E? Will you find out that, now?
Yes, sir.
Find out. Yes.
Zero.
Anna?
3/2 root 2, sir.
3/2. Root 2 times. I think the sine E is equals to 3/4 root 2. Here I think these two are not get cancelled. Okay. This is sine 4/3
by 2.
By root 2 means that for you. Root 2 times. Then this will be 2/3 is equals to 1/2 sine E. So sine E is equals to I think 3/4 root 2, correct? Here. Suppose again, this is one parallel sided glass. Previously, light incident on the first surface AB. Finally, after refraction, emerges from the surface CD. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Means previous concepts, the two examples are related to the light finally refracts at the two parallel sides. Okay. Now, this example is related to light incident on the surface AB at some angle of incidence. I don't know that angle of incidence. And here, after refraction, unfortunately, the light rays incidenting on the vertical side, not parallel side. Okay. Why? Because these two are perpendicular to each other, vertical side. And after incidenting on the vertical side, suppose at a point, say this is point E and this is the point F. Okay. It is trying to come from denser medium of means glass, denser medium, mu is equals to root 3 pk, and trying to come out into rarer medium. Okay. Now the question is, if the medium, total surrounding medium is A, even here also, and not finding out, one is not, means one person, is not finding the light in air. Okay. Means light is not coming into the air again. Light is not coming into the air means light after refraction, taking a refracting angle of exactly here, means actually angle of emergence, we say here. Am I right, Nana?
It's a TIR.
Trying to take a TIR, but here, what is the minimum angle of incidence here? Not to find out the light in air. Minimum angle of incidence means minimum TIR. That is, it should graze the face like this. The light ray should come grazing the face like this.
Yes, sir.
If it is so.
Critical angle kanna takku undalaga, sir.
Means actually it is grazing the surface means here the angle of incidence with the normal means this is with the normal. Should be critical angle. Am I right? if the angle of incidence here is less than that critical angle, it will come into air.
Yes, sir.
If I angle of incidence here is equal to the critical angle, grazes the interface.
Yes, sir.
Okay, means touching that interface. If I greater than C, you know, angle of incidence here is greater than C, then total internal reflection will take place.
Sir.
Okay, I think you know that concept. We know that concept, Nana?
Yes, sir.
So here he is saying that it grazes the face beams. Here the angle of refraction in there, which we are taking it as the emerging angle, that is equals to 90 degrees exactly. 90 degrees beams. Here inside the angle of incidence should be critical. Okay.
90 minus C equal to R.
Where, very good, very good. So angle of refraction here will be 90 minus C. Then will you apply Snell's law here?
Yes, sir.
Snell's law at what phase now? AB.
Mu 2 by mu 1 equal to sin I by sin 90 minus C.
Mu 2 by mu 1 means root 3 by 1. Then I think root 3 is equal to just I got sin I by cos C. Sin 90 minus C is cos C. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Then you want C, Nana. Otherwise, I can't find out. He is asking what is the angle of incidence, minimum angle of incidence.
Sir.
Then why don't you apply again the Snell's law at the surface BD?
Sin C by sin 90 equal to mu.
Sin C by sin 90 equals to light is coming from glass to air means mu 2 by mu 1.
Air by glass.
Air by glass. Means air, refractive index 1. Glass given as root 3. Am I right, Hana?
Yes, sir.
So you are getting, I think, sin C is equals to 1 by root 3. But I require cos C. Sorry, 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Then what will be the adjacent sign on it?
Cos C equal to 2 by root 3.
2 by root 3 or root 2 by root 3?
Root 2, sir.
Cos C is equal, so on adjacent side will be
root
of hypotenuse square minus side square. That is equal to root 2. So root 2 by root 3. Therefore, I think you can say sin I now. Okay. That implies sin I equals to cross multiplication. Root 3 into cos C. Cos C how much now?
Sin I equal to root 2, sir.
Sin I equals to root 2. Actually, sin I equals to root 2 means in this question, I think we took something wrong now. Why? Because sin I equals to root 2, which is greater than 1 now.
Yes, sir.
Greater than 1 sin angles or cos angles not possible, kada?
No, sir.
So better we take it as some 3 instead of root 3.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then it will become 3. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And here also this will be 1 by 3. Then what will be cos C? If it is 1 by 3, then what will be the adjacent side?
Root 8, sir.
Right. This will be root 8. So cos C will be root 8 by 3. I think now you will get some proper answer or not.
We'll get, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Oh. I equals to how much? If you change mu to root of 3 by 2, then we are getting the proper answer.
Yeah.
That implies I equals to how much, man? Exactly?
See, sir.
Right, I equals. Okay. Know that concept. What you know? Suppose light comes from denser medium to rarer medium. Okay. At one angle of incidence, it tries to refract, bends towards the surface, away from the normal and towards the surface. Yeah. If I is less than the critical angle, okay, then light enters into the rarer medium or enters into the denser medium?
Denser, sir.
Light, I is less than critical angle. Okay, okay. What is meant by critical angle?
Denser నుంచి రేరర్ మీడియం కి వెళ్ళేటప్పుడు యాంగిల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ లైన్ వచ్చి క్రిటికల్ యాంగిల్ కన్నా ఈక్వల్ గా చేస్తే అది గ్రేస్ అవుతుంది సార్
టువర్డ్స్ అంటే గ్రేస్ ఇస్ ద ఫేస్ కదా
yes sir
if I equals to c then only r equals to you are saying how much angle of refraction with the normal
90 sir
Thank you. Very good. If I equals to C, then R equals to 90.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Means simple logic. If I is less than C, then R will be less than 90 or greater than 90.
Less than 90, sir.
Then R is less than 90 means less than 90. Light should come like this, Karanana.
Yes, sir.
The angle of refraction should be less than 90. Means it is coming into the rare medium or coming into the denser medium, the refracted one. That's what I asked. So here the light, okay, refracts into the rarer medium. Okay. In this case, you told that if I equals to C, R equals to 90. Then where is the light? After refraction.
On the surface, sir.
After refraction, the light is actually neither in rare medium nor in denser medium. It is after refraction, the light grazes the surface. Its interface, common surface of both. Okay. In this case, I think already you saw here what is sin c. Apply the Snell's law here. Light is coming from denser to rarer. Denser to rarer. Who is the second medium?
Rarer.
So mu 2 by mu 1. Mu rarer by mu denser.
Yes, sir. Equals. Equal to sin c by sin r.
Sin c by sin r. R how much? Then here sin c is equals to you are telling that
mu r.
That keeping up. Sin c is equals to mu r by mu. Okay, this is the formula when the light grazes the surface.
Yes, sir.
In this case already at the initial stage today while starting the class you told that what will be the angle of deviation.
R minus.
That already you told. Okay. In this case, will you tell the angle of deviation now? Simple. 90
90 minus
I. I how much?
C, yes. Sir.
90 minus C. Means 5 by 2 minus C is the angle of deviation at the time of critical angle. Okay, Nana? If, in this case, if I is greater than critical angle, okay, I usually this is rarer and this is denser. Light is coming from denser medium to rarer medium, but angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. Then angle of refraction should be greater than 90 or less than 90?
I greater than C, no, sir.
Greater than I is greater than C. R should be
greater than 0.
if I is equals to C, you told R equals to 90.
Yes, sir.
I is less than C, you told R is less than 90. Yes, if sir. I is greater than C?
Greater than C, 90, sir.
So simple logic. And means we are actually taking the reference as 90 degrees. Okay? Less than 90, here, greater than 90. Greater than 90 means the angle of refraction should be more than 90 degrees. Then the refracted light ray should be in the same denser medium or rare medium?
Denser, sir.
So this is the refracted light ray and angle of refraction with the normal. It is obtuse angle more than 90. Okay, na? This is the case of what, Nana? Total internal reflection. Okay. In this case, what do you say? Okay, I already wrote I is greater than C, then R is greater than 90. Then after refraction, the light enters into the rare medium or denser medium?
Denser, sir.
Into the same denser medium. Okay, very good. Then, if I is almost close to critical angle, can I say using the reflection principle, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection?
Yes, sir.
So, can I write it is also I?
Yes, sir.
If it is I, that is also I. In case of what? TIR. Okay? In this case, will you say what will be the angle of deviation? Is this much angle of deviation? D.
R minus.
Till here, you know it is 2I.
Sir.
I plus I.
Yes, sir. 2I, sir.
2I. But total angle to up to here?
180.
So I am asking the remaining angle.
180 minus 2i.
That's it. So 180 pi minus 2i. Okay, Nana? This one previously we asked in exam why I is greater than C. Okay. Means C is supposed 45 degrees, Nana. I is close to C, like 45.2 degrees Celsius. Sorry, 45.2 degrees angle. Okay. These two are approximately equal, kada?
Yes, sir.
Not exactly, approximately equal. Then why don't you write D is approximately equals to pi minus 2C?
Yes, sir.
Instead of I, what I am writing, Nana? Why? If they are very close to each other, then we can replace I with C. Okay, na? Okay, right. So originally angle of deviation is pi minus 2i. If I is approximately equal to C, but greater than C, then we can write D is approximately equals to pi minus 2.
Okay, sir.
Right. Very good. Means from the first information given in the diagram here, the angle of incidence is given, angle of refraction is given, light is coming from air to denser medium. Yes, in this case, I think you can find out mu.
Yes, sir.
Second by first, mu by 1, air equals to sin I.
1 by root 2 by 1 by 2. Root 2, sir.
Very good. Mu equals to root 2. When light comes from rarer to denser. Okay. So you found the mu of this medium now. Now you know mu equals to root 2 here. But this time what he is saying, light is not coming from air to denser medium now. Light is coming from denser to air. Okay. At some angle of incidence, but the light gets total internal reflection here. means to get the total internal refraction, I should be greater than critical angle or less than critical angle? So pakka you know. So I is greater than critical angle. Okay. In this case.
Yes.
Can I apply sin on both sides, ma'am?
Sin A, sin C.
Very good. But the sin C previously I gave one formula. Mu of rarer to denser or mu rarer by mu denser or mu denser by mu rarer?
Mu rarer by mu denser, sir.
Right. Rarer, A, 1, by denser. How much is this, ma'am? Root 2. Then the critical angle, sin C will be how much, ma'am?
45.
C is 45. Very good. Okay, right. Sin C is 1 by root 2 or C is equals to 45 degrees. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then what will be the answer? That implies I can write I should be greater than critical angle 45 degrees or sin I is greater than 1 by root. Am I right, Hana?
Yes,
sir. So, wisely we have to choose the options. Suppose here he gave the four options, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. First option, 45 degrees. Second option, 38 degrees. Fourth option, 42 degrees. Fifth option, 47 degrees.
47.
Right. So these two straight away wrong. I is less than C.
Yes, sir.
Okay. But why are you not choosing this option exactly equals to 45? So I should be greater than 45 means we have to choose the option 47 degrees from the given four options.
Yes, sir.
Here you take this is right angled isosceles prism.
Okay. Sir.
Right angled isosceles prism and light ray incident on the surface light. Okay. And it gets some total internal reflection here and tries to enter into the water from the base. Okay. Here at the base, what will be the angle of refraction? Means angle of emergence. Suppose it comes out like this. Okay. What will be the angle of emergence? Here the refractive index of this medium is take it as 3/2. Okay. If I give like this, I think first of all, what do you say, Nana?
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Okay. In the diagram here, Nana, while taking the total internal reflection, it is the angle of incidence. Of course, angle of reflection also, here the other angle also, same. But this one I told it is right angled isosceles prism. Right?
Yes, sir.
Isosceles prism means, do you know what are the remaining two angles?
45, 45.
Very good. If it is 45, what is this angle? Okay, I will draw the diagram little bit big here, Nana. Bigger one. Very good. So here with the normal, if it is 45 degrees, okay, with the normal, this angle is also 45 degrees. I think you understood.
Yes, sir.
45 means this is also 45, so remaining angle will be 45. Very good. Means here the angle of incidence is, you are telling that 45 degrees.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I is equals to 45 and that 45 is greater than critical angle. Okay. Leave it. Okay. 45 means this angle is also
45.
So this angle is also 45 degrees. Okay. This is 45 means what is the total angle here, Nana?
90.
This is exactly 90 means keep in mind. This comes straight away, strikes the base perpendicular to the base.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
why? Because the incident light ray is parallel to the this. The reflected, total internal reflected light ray is parallel to this side. Okay. So here, this is parallel to the side means exactly perpendicular to this side. Why? Because it is right angled isosceles. Then
sir,
the angle of incidence here.
Zero, sir.
I is equals to zero means I think nothing to do. What will be? Angle of refraction outside will be zero or something. Therefore, that implies the angle of emergence is equals to zero. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Observe this question. Same question. Okay, little bit change. Okay. This is, suppose, completely immersed in water. Not like to partially, some part in air, some other part in water, no, previous problem. Now it is completely immersed in water.
Okay.
Here, it is trying to take total internal reflection again at this phase. Okay, same like this. After incidenting, takes total internal reflection here. Means nothing to explain. The angle of incidence here equals to 45 degrees and the angle of reflection is also 45 degrees. Nothing to explain. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And here, I am not asking anything here that already we did in the above problem. So I am not asking at the base. My question is, suppose the refractive index of surrounding medium water is 4 by 3, what will be the refractive index of this prism? Mu equals to how much? If I ask, how you start the problem?
It's coming from denser to rarer, sir. Water by mu denser equal to sin A by sin R.
Again, you are going in a wrong way now. Sin I by sin R means here you can't apply. Why? Because I equals to zero. So angle of refraction, nothing to find, that also zero.
Yes, sir.
And from the previous knowledge, already we found here angle of incidence again zero. So angle of emergence zero. So here you can't apply Snell's law. There also you can't apply Snell's law. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Here you should not apply the Snell's law. Why? Because there it is taking total internal reflection.
Sir.
So you should not apply Snell's law. So for total internal reflection, what you know?
Exactancy, sir.
That's it. So every time if there is total internal reflection, don't try to apply the Snell's law.
Okay, sir. Exactancy.
Just to recollect, that's it. Oh, I know total internal reflection. I know only one thing. I is greater than C. Sin I is greater than sin C. Okay. Here I think this time I know,
sir.
I think this time you know the angle of incidence here.
45, 1 by root 2.
1 by root 2 is greater than sin C.
Sin C is less than 1 by root 2.
Very good. Sin C is less than 1 by root 2. Sin C, what is the formula?
Sin mu r by mu d, sir.
Means second medium by first medium. Second medium. Who is the second medium? Sorry, mu rarer. Mu rarer to mu denser. Now. Correct,
yes,
enough? Mu rarer means out of these two, which is rarer? This is rarer.
Yes,
how to decide? How to decide? That is your doubt, I think. Simple. Light is taking total internal reflection means light should come from denser to rarer. Then only light takes total internal reflection. Correct,
Anna? Okay,
so who is rarer?
Water.
Water, refractive index.
4 by 3.
So according to the formula mu r by mu d equals to sin c. In place of sin c, I am substituting mu r by mu d. Okay, Anna? Is less than 1 by root 2, mu r 4 by 3 by mu d is less than 1 by root 2.
Yes, sir.
Reciproc. 3 mu d by 4.
Greater than root 2.
Therefore, mu d, I am asking. Mu d. Are you able to see this one, Anand?
Yes, sir. Mu d, 4 greater than 4 d, 4 root 2 by 3.
So 4 root 2 by 3. This is the final answer. So mu d is greater than 4 root 2 by 3. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.